MEPs attend to some serious nuts and bolts of European politics for the plenary session in Strasbourg. The Commission's work programme next year, midterm revisions to the EU's five-year budget, protecting fundamental rights, and naming the Sakharov Prize winner. Many MEPs say a recent rollback of democratic values in Poland and Hungary reflects a wider erosion of fundamental rights in Europe. Now they want action. They're calling for a new mechanism to monitor the state of democracy, rule of law and fundamental rights in EU member states on an annual basis, and to propose ways of fixing breaches. They'll be voting on a draft resolution on Tuesday. There are two clear messages to the Commission on the EU's long-term spending plans: more financial headroom to meet unforeseen crises such as disasters, refugees, terrorism or security, and a crisis fund must be well resourced. On Wednesday, MEPs discuss a midterm revision of the 2014 to 2020 budget, known as the Multiannual Financial Framework, with Commissioner Kristalina Georgieva. They had hoped for more resources, but for the Commission, these remain unchanged. MEPs are hoping to wrap up negotiations by the end of the year. They'll also be voting on the 2017 budget. Wednesday also sees a big debate with Jean-Claude Juncker and Donald Tusk, presidents of the European Commission and Council respectively, on the outcome of the October summit of heads of state and government. Key issues: EU-Russia relations, including the sanctions regime, expanding European defence options, and the troubled EU-Canada trade agreement, CETA. A bit of Brexit, no doubt, also. Much, if not all, of this will inevitably spill into 2017, and the Commission's work programme for next year will come under scrutiny in a debate on Tuesday. Alive to current European political winds, MEPs say social rights, jobs and security should head the priorities. Now, in brief, some other items coming up in plenary. A resolution before Parliament on Wednesday seeks to place mandatory limits on industrially produced trans fatty acids, which risk cardiovascular disease, Alzheimer's and obesity. Following the historic nuclear deal with Iran, MPs want the EU to shift relations to a new level, expanding trade and de-escalating regional tensions. The debate is on Monday and a vote on Tuesday. The threats, acts of aggression and restrictions that journalists face in Turkey are debated on Wednesday. Since the failed coup, 90 journalists have been jailed and more than 2,500 have lost their jobs. Finally, the winner of the Sakharov Prize for Freedom of Thought 2016 is to be announced. The candidates are Can Dündar, former editor-in-chief of the leading Turkish opposition newspaper Cumhuriyet, Mustafa Cemilev, champion for decades of Crimean Tatar rights, and jointly Nadia Murad Basi Taha and Lamia Aji Bashar, both advocates for the Yazidi community in Iraq and survivors of sexual enslavement by so-called Islamic State. The announcement is due to be made on Thursday. And that's it for this roundup of key moments in plenary. Enjoy the week. Seems to be a little bit of a thing.